We're going to take you down the hall now and show you some living quarters. In the old barge, there was one room for girls, one room for boys, and I think Chad had a little teeny office space and a bed. But now each one has their own room. You need something to call your own, and each one has their own bedroom. There's two nice-sized bathrooms at the end, and there's a laundry area right before that. The women's bathroom was a multi-purpose because it's handicap accessible. That was not available on the old barge. And then I'm going to take you into the communal kitchen, which is kind of a cool place. Then we're going to go upstairs, if you dare. And if you want to come back, you can spend as much time as you want in this room with the resources she has. And you can also get down to the basement. A barge has a basement. It's very interesting. I think the old barge might have had 500 gallons of water or 15, and this one has 35,000 gallons of water. It's huge.
The last one had less than 2,000.
Less than 2,000? I thought it was 1,500, I think.
It might be written somewhere on one of these.
I was looking for that, but it's phenomenal. I don't you have 35,000 gallons?
Yeah, it's over 30,000 now.
Yeah.
Do you remember, like, what was the roughest year for Chad when he started doing this? Do you remember?
I do. I remember, let's see, it was like into his second year, and Rodney Shaw was helping him, and they were on the Illinois River. And I went there to talk to him and, you know, just encourage him a little bit. And it was, I think, out of Morris or somewhere around Morris, Illinois. And went there, and they would, they had the boat on the shore, and they'd walk and get a piece of garbage, and then walk back to the boat and just, like, throw it in there. You know, they were so sick of doing it.
Yeah.
You know, but it was, they toughed it out and finished the year. You know, it was in the fall, and kind of, leaves are changing a little bit, and the end was in sight, but that was, that's the one I remember. I think that's when CNN picked
up the story.
Picked it up, and then things got kind of lively. You know, after that, got a lot of recognition, and he got more encouragement. Really, you know, it pumped him up.
Again, Chad's forte is being a catalyst to get different people working together. Whether it's the Audubon Society working with the barging people. In the fall, well, he's got the tree planting, and that's where a lot of that CNN money went. They've got a site over in Davenport off 53rd. It's 8 acres. The city, I virtually gave it to him, but nothing's for free. He's taken his tree plantings and seedlings, which used to be down in southern Illinois. It took 4 or 5 hours to drive the people down there. He's moved that up here. He's punched in a well. They're going to have interpretive trails, nature area, in that area. So there's payback to the city and to the local people. So we've got the education workshop. We've got the trees where he wants to plant 1 million trees. So far, he's up to about 700, over 700,000 trees.